In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit,
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Amen.
Dear brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to my brothers and sisters that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask the Blessed Mary, a Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me, Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who through the grace of adoption chose us to be children of light, grant, we pray, that we may not be wrapped in the darkness of error, but always be seen to stand in the bright light of truth. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Please turn to page 1038. 1038 of the Old Testament, reading from the book of Amos, chapter 7, verses 10 to 17. Go prophesy to my people, reading from the book of Amos, chapter 7, verses 10 to 17. Then Amaziah, the priest of Bethel, sent to King Jeroboam of Israel, saying, Amos has conspired against you in the very center of the house of Israel. The land is not able to bear all his words. For thus Amos has said, Jeroboam shall die by the sword, and Israel must go into exile away from his land. And Amaziah said to Amos, O seer, go flee away to the land of Judah. Earn your bread there and prophesy there, but never again prophesy at Bethel, for it is the king's sanctuary, and it is the temple of the kingdom. Then Amos answered Amaziah, I am no prophet, nor a prophet's son, but I am a herdsman and a dresser of sycamore trees. And the Lord took me from following the flock, and the Lord said to me, Go prophesy to my people Israel. Now therefore hear the word of the Lord. You say, do not prophesy against Israel, and do not preach against the house of Isaac. Therefore, thus says the Lord, your wife shall become a prostitute in the city, and your sons and your daughters shall fall by the sword, and your land shall be parceled out by line. You yourself shall die in an unclean land, and Israel shall surely go into exile away from its land. The word of the Lord. Response: The decrees of the Lord are truth, The decrees of the Lord are truth, and all of them just. The law of the Lord is perfect, it revives the soul. The rule of the Lord is to be trusted, it gives wisdom to the simple. Response: the decrees of the Lord are truth, and all of them just. The precepts of the Lord are right, they gladden the heart. The command of the Lord is clear, it gives light to the eyes. Response: the decrees of the Lord are truth, and all of them just. The fear of the Lord is holy, abiding forever. The decrees of the Lord are truth, and all of them just. Response: the decrees of the Lord are truth, and all of them just. They are more to be desired than gold, than the purest of gold, and sweeter are they than honey, that honey from the comb. Response: the decrees of the Lord are truth, and all of them just. Acclamation.
Alleluia. Alleluia. Alleluia.
May the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ,
may the Word of the Lord Jesus Christ,
enlighten the eyes of our heart, enlighten the eyes,
so that we may know
the hope to which He has called us.
Alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew, chapter 9, verses 1 to 8. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew, chapter 9, verses 1 to 8. Getting into a boat, Jesus crossed over and came to his own city, Capernaum. And behold, they brought to him a paralytic lying on his bed. And when Jesus saw their faith, he said to the paralytic, "Take heart, my son, your sins are forgiven." And behold, some of the scribes said to themselves, "This man is blaspheming." But Jesus, knowing their thoughts, said, "Why do you think evil in your hearts? For which is easier to say, 'Your sins are forgiven,' or to say, 'Rise and walk'? But that you may know that the Son of Man has authority on earth to forgive sins," he then said to the paralytic, "Rise, take up your bed and go home." And he rose and went home. When the crowd saw it, they were afraid, and they glorified God who had given such authority to men. This is the Gospel of the Lord. Dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, in the first reading we see in the northern kingdom, in the temple of Bethel, Amaziah, who was a priest, who is taking care of the people of Israel, but the Lord has sent Prophet Amos to go and proclaim the word of God in the northern kingdom. When he was started proclaiming about the word of God, when the people are receiving the word of God, when it is changing and transforming them, the temple priest Amaziah, he could not able to digest, and he wrote a letter to the king of Israel, Jeroboam, about Amos. When Amaziah received the letter from the king Jeroboam, he said to Amos, "Go back to the southern kingdom, and there you go and proclaim the word of God, so that those people may pay you for according to your deeds." Then Amos said, "It is not that I am paying and receiving the word of God. Word of God has given freely for me, and I am giving to the same word of God to the people. It is the Lord who has appointed me as a prophet. I am only a shepherd man, and I am only taking care of the fig trees. I am not going to make money by proclaiming the word of God. When he said this thing, then the Messiah told him, then you go back to the southern kingdom of Judah, where the people could able to receive the word of God. The word of God, which was dwelling inside Prophet Amos, it became very furious, and then and there he cursed the priest of Bethel, Amaziah, because he is misleading the people of Israel in the northern kingdom. In the gospel reading, Jesus has given the beautiful message that when we have the gift of forgiveness, when we forgive others, all our sins will be forgiven and we will receive the healing. Here in the first reading, Prophet Amos, he was freely proclaiming the word of God. In Jesus' time, when Jesus was saying about the kingdom of God, the people who received the words of Jesus Christ, the words which touched the people, it has transformed them, it has changed them. That's why they followed Jesus Christ. Even Jesus was sitting in a home, they brought the paralytic on a bed where Jesus was. They surrendered themselves to Jesus and offered the paralytic man to Jesus. When Jesus saw, because of his sins which were very heavy, he could not able to receive the healing, he could not able to receive the forgiveness from others. That's why Jesus said to him, your sins are forgiven, arise and walk. Today the same Jesus is saying to each and every one of us that which all the sins are there, we must surrender to the Lord so that the Lord may give us pardon and mercy. He may show compassion to us. When we show compassion, mercy towards others when they are in sinful state, the same Lord will show the compassion to us. The same measure he will give us when we measure others, when we judge others. Today, as Jesus, so much of compassion, he has forgiven the paralytic man, showing that all people, those who are observed the healing of Jesus Christ, he wants the same compassion to be in each and every one of us, because we all are adopted sons and daughters of Jesus. We must rise and walk to the will of God, to do the will of God in the right path. In all the time, we must do the righteous thing. As Jesus was faithful, he wants all the people, those who are around Jesus Christ, to be faithful, to be trustful in him. The word of God, which has contained the life in the words of Jesus Christ, which has uttered by Jesus Christ, today the same words has to come out from our mouth, so that when we utter the words, it has to bring healing to other people, it has to bring forgiveness when we utter the words to others. Today, in this Holy Eucharist, ask the Lord to send down his Holy Spirit upon each and every one of us, all the people, those who are suffering, all the people, those who are hearing the word of God, all the people, those who are facing lot of trials, difficulties in their life, all the people, those who are in depression, those who are in various diseases, so that the word may give the healing power, the word of God may touch and strengthen them, so that they will be doing the will of God and all the time following his path. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
We praise the Lord. us and you say that we be approved in the work of human hands, it should become for us a bread of life. Blessed be God. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Let us pray. O God, who graciously accomplished the effects of your mysteries, grant, we pray, that the deeds by which we serve you may be worthy of these sacred gifts. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, to Christ our Lord. For out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from the unending death, and by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so with the angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray the partaking of the body and bread of Christ may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Tumabala Archbishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all you have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with St. Joseph, our spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, may merit to be coerced eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not in temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
May the bringing of the body and blood of Lord Jesus Christ bring it to life to us, in the body and blood of Lord Jesus Christ, not bring judgment and condemnation, but your love and mercy be from protection and body and healing remedy. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life. Amen.
The birth of his purpose of the marriage and woman. If you knew the gift of God,
You are the good and the best of the angels from above. Of the God of might and mercy, Father, of the Lord, of the Lord, of the Lord, let the church be of the fulfilled in the world, its God is and glorified. You will that the ministers is also be clothed in meekness, in order that they may give compassion and those in whom there is an error. Let everyone who opposes them be sought after, loved and forgiven by God. Send your spirit and run to everyone who has been forgiven, so that the duty of mercy is greater of grace from the Lord. And your church will renew enthusiasm, may bring good news to the poor, proclaim liberty to the captives and the oppressed, and just the sight of the blind. We ask for the intercession of Mary, Mother of Mercy, you who live and reign with the Father of the Holy Spirit, forever and ever. Amen. Please take the prayer in the sacred heart. Sacred heart of Jesus, remember that we are consecrated and belong to you. Bless and protect us all. Make our marriage the shrine of your love and grace. Strengthen the bond that unites us together. Help us to bear one another's burdens in peace, harmony, and unselfishness. Keep us always near to you and your blessed Mother. Amen.
Come in an antiphon. O Father, I pray for them, that they may be one in us, that the world may believe that you have sent me, says the Lord. Let us pray. May this divine sacrifice we have offered and received fill us with life, O Lord, we pray, so that, bound to you in lasting charity, we may bear fruit that lasts forever. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace and joy of Christ.
Hymn number 81,
page 1.